All right, hello guys. We have switched over to the last thing we're going to be doing during the stream, which is play this game. This game is called Super Lesbian Animal RPG. It's a game that I actually originally heard about lurking on Tumblr and seeing this game development blog. I was instantly entranced because why not? Why would I not be? This is everything I'm about. Everything I'm about. Plus the colors and just the way the game is styled, the art. I love it so much. So I was very excited when this game finally officially released. I believe it was at the beginning of this year or the end of last year. It was very recent. And it was actually on my poll for a game to start the new year with. Did not win, but it did get a lot of votes. So I decided that I would play it after finishing Pokemon Conquest. It's actually a really nice game because, it's still available on Steam. I think it's still, it is of course available on Steam. I think it might still be on sale because it was recently published. If it's not, feel free to correct me. But even if it's not on sale, it is a, independently made game. So I recommend buying it because then you get to support the development team. It is a game title. Fun fact, this is one game that you can't put the full title in Twitch, because Twitch does not let you say one of those words on a stream title. I wonder which word it is. Do you guys have a guess which word it is? So, but you can still, play it, obviously. Just, it's funny that I'm not allowed to put the actual name of the game in the title. It's fun. But we're going to play it. I have not seen anything except like screenshots of parts of the game. So we'll be experiencing this together. I'm very excited to play this. Why don't we go ahead and get started? I'm going to learn the buttons. What are the buttons? Okay. F1 is settings, F5 toggle full screen, blah blah. Max display size will distort pixels. Yep, so I'm playing this on the window that it's normally play on. Z to continue. Okay, here we go. Sprint, select, menu, cancel. Okay, and then move. All right, easy. So these buttons. It also supports gamepad. I did not connect my gamepad, unfortunately. Okay, normal. The way the game was designed to be played offers a moderate challenge for fans of RPGs, or easy for those who care more about the story than the challenge. I obviously want normal. Give me normal gameplay. Enable additional guidance. You'll occasionally get a... Sorry, my voice. You'll occasionally get a more direct hint on what to do next, denoted with blue text. Let me think about that. I did pretty good on Wind Waker without help, right? What's the worst that could happen if I decide to go with not that? We'll take it. We'll take the blue text. The second most useful positive review on Steam is just gay. Nothing more to be said. That's all I need to know. Honestly. By the way, again, let me know if the game audio needs to be adjusted, and I will do so. It may or may not be loud. It seems like it's loud, but let me know if it's okay. Over 1,000 years ago, the goddess Fortuna granted the mortals of her planet the gift of magic. Okay, that's what I thought. It seemed like it was too loud. Is that better? The single act of kindness forever changed the course of history. Now able to harness the art of the gods, the mortals flourished in this new arcane era. Grand cities powered by magic were built. Plagues were cured. The lands were connected by new means of transport. Centuries later, most people have grown accustomed to their fantastical reality. Magic now coexists with modern technology as a part of everyday life. But even today, many young people still find themselves chasing dreams of fame, glory, and moderate financial stability with the help of magic. These people seek to become adventurers. The Sapphire Islands, where all the sapphics live. Hey, what if we met a dragon or something? Pretty cool. Look at Allison, she's cute. There's Melody. We'll be playing Melody in this story. Surely we've already met a dragon at some point. What about back in high school? Wasn't one of our classmates a dragon? Are you thinking of Josh? He's an armadillo lizard, not a dragon. Oh, yeah. What about you, though? Anything you want to do as an adventure? Maybe. Maybe we could, I guess I haven't put that much thought into it. I don't know, I'm not too picky. Hey, be honest with me, Mel. Are you still down for this Adventurers Guild thing with Claire and Jody? Well, you're excited, right? This is a great opportunity for you. You know I'm pumped, and I'm grateful that you want to support me. But this is a huge undertaking for you, too. I mean, of course I'm nervous. And yeah, our lack of tangible progress so far hasn't been the biggest confidence booster. But we're doing it together, right? At the end of the day, I think that makes it worth trying. That's the spirit! We'll be the coolest fighting duo Greenridge has ever seen. And man, how lucky I am to have such a cute adventuring partner. Oh, stop. Get a room, you two! Who's that? Who's there? Weren't you in the middle of something important? Oh, duh. Hey, Fakazoo. Thank you for the birthday wishes. Happy birthday to me. I got a cake. And my age does not rhyme with any of it. But hey, welcome, welcome. Thanks for dropping by. Oh, duh. Come on, Mel. Let's finish this little treasure hunt. Now let's see. The next clue is, travel north until you find the spot where two paths cross. Okay. Oh, I move now. Okay. north. Well, what's over here, actually? I want to see over here. Nothing. Okay. Aw, thank you, Fawkinsie. I appreciate that. Thank you. I think this is it. Nice work, Mel. Yeah, this does look like an X on the ground. Well, I mean, this is less two paths crossing and more like a big X on made with dirt. But this is probably it. Now let's see. The next clue is, from there, search for the lonely tree. Okay. The lonely tree. That looks like a lonely tree to me. Aw, look at how cute we are. Look at this. We're so cute. I love us. Oh, wait. Melody Amaranth. Freelancer. A lot of defense and luck. Oh, wow. I'm lucky. 22, trans girl. Bye. A timid fox who lives out in the woods. She's worried she hasn't been pulling her weight as the team's de facto leader. Aw, don't worry, Melody, you're fine. Allison Goleta, woodcutter. Very good defense. Also, okay, her defense and luck are better than mine, actually. Squishy. Squishy, squishy, squishy. Thanks for the pat-pats, Halo. 22, cis lesbian, she/her. An adventurous bunny who may be in over her head. She loves punk rock, her girlfriend, and the sound of her own voice. Did the stream category not change? Hold on. I thought I said it. How about now? Did it change? Is Twitch being weird about this game stream title? On. Okay, thank you, Nightbot. Let me see. Does anyone see the game? Is it not showing up? Okay, no problem. Thank you for checking it, though. Oh, right. I'm sorry. I forgot about the tree. Here's the tree. I found the tree. What do I do with it? This looks like the loneliest tree out here. I can just touch it. I don't know. Doesn't look lonely to me. Am I winning lesbianism? I mean, I already have a really cute girlfriend, so I think I am. Both in real life and in the game. I don't know, it doesn't look lonely to me. Feels like that's projecting our expectations for how it should feel. Please cease the out-of-pocket comments about the quality of the clues. Who is talking to us? Now let's... Oh wait, I think I see something up ahead. Oh, wait, hold on, don't leave me. Don't leave me in the woods alone. Oh, it's a chest. For your final test, you must use your wits to discern the identity of the one who has summoned you here. Is it Claire? Claire, what are you doing? Wait, Claire, what are you doing? There's Claire. Oh, come on. Was it really that obvious? I mean, who else would slide directions for a scavenger run under my door this late at night? Okay, true. So, what exactly is the point of this? Is this more training or something? Then no. I needed to get you in an adventurous mood to prepare you for what happens next. Now, our guild missions over the last few months have been... less than optimal. Yeah, we know. But what if I told you I have something that could change that? I love Claire's hat. Whoa, what are you doing, Claire? What I have here is... What? Claire! Claire! Ooh, wow, the art is really cute. Look at that. Behemoth boar. Okay, attack, let's just go for it. Oh my god, Allison! Allison, no! Okay, this might be bad. Oh god! It's okay. Hold, huh? The behemoth board chomps down on Allison's cheap sword, shattering it. Ah, crap. Flee! We can't flee? We have no items! Attack it! Oh my god, we can't kill it! We just fell a little bit. Claire! Get out of here, you! Oh, good. Okay, Claire, you got this, right? Let me take one. Just one. Which one? The one on the left or the one on the right? Allison, are you hurt? I have survived worse. I'm just glad you're okay. So, that wasn't part of the plan. But I'm impressed by what I just saw. What, me getting my butt kicked yet again? A lot of people would have given up after so many setbacks. But not you two. Your hearts are in the right place and you're willing to put in the work. You just need the power to back it up. Which is why I have this. This book contains our sacred ritual passed down to us by Fortuna, the goddess of magic herself. It also has an absurd amount of magical energy, which I think is what attracted that monster just now.
Whoa, where did you get that?
Oh, I found it while exploring. Nothing suspicious about that. So, as the story goes, when Fortuna first taught magic to us mortals way back when, nobody had the training required to cast spells. But instead of giving up on us, Fortuna came up with a ritual to awaken her acolytes' Latin magical abilities. And I just so happen to have the instructions for that right here. It won't give you the powers of a goddess, and you'll still need a lot of practice. But it will give you a running start. You just have to answer a few questions for me. What do you say? Let's do it. Nah, let's not. Is this cheating? Is it really fair to just get magical powers for free? People work hard for those. I mean, it's not free. You'll still have to work very, very hard to figure out how to do anything with your new mana. What's really unfair is the thought of you two being left in the dust just because you didn't have your whole lives planned out at the age of 14. I mean, come on. You probably would have started training years ago if you knew adventuring wasn't a pipe dream. This is just a nudge in the right direction to make up for lost time. Okay, when you put it like that, this sounds like just what we needed.
Well, if Mel's in, then I'm in.
Excellent. Let's start with you, Melody. Why do you want to be an adventurer? Well, Allison wants to join you and Jody in your guild, but she knows I'd be worried sick if she ran off without me. So I thought, well, I'm not really doing anything else with my life. Maybe I could go with her and look out for her, try to keep her safe. I see. I'm not the best fighter, so I think I'd be more useful if I had healing magic. I mean, I've tried being the healer, but without magic, all I can really do is hand out potions. And I don't want to keep being the team water girl. I assumed as much. You'd make a great cleric. Well, not quite. I was thinking I'd rather be a paladin.
Oh, Melody, Melody's dreaming big.
Really? Like a noble crusader with a code of honor and all that jazz? You sure? I just like the sound of it. I've been reading up on my options a lot and, well, I don't know, I just like the sound of it.
You don't sound at all confident in your choice.
No, this is what I want. I'm sure of it.
That's better.
And you, Allison?
Well, you know me. Adventuring's in my blood. I just want to be strong and fight monsters, really.
Care to be a little more specific?
Evil monsters would be preferable. I don't have any reason to fight night monsters.
Okay, smartass. But, if that's all you're gonna give me to work with, you don't get to complain if you think your powers suck.
No promises.
Great. Now, let's begin the ritual.
What do you think, guys, what do you think Allison's gonna end up being? I kind of am putting my bets on Ranger because of what she said, but I don't know.
Oh dear. Relax, it's just a little spell. I'm following the instructions to the letter. Is this dangerous?
Oh, absolutely. Whoa, this place looks cool. Someone got to get a bow at some point.
True.
Someone's got to be the range fighter.
Melody, are you still with us? Can you hear me? Huh? Oh, yes, I can hear you, Claire.
You had us worried there for a second.
Dang, I wish I could see what you're seeing. Wherever your consciousness right now. Anyway, Allison didn't need as much magic, so she's already done. But I've still got a few final preparations to make for you, Melody. I suggest you look around a bit while you wait.
It's very beautiful in here. I like all the stars. Oh, and there's moons, too. Can I just walk? Nope. Well, I can walk on the star bit. Go here. Can I go here? It's so pretty. I'm walking in the space. Very rainbow, very... Wait. There's a person there. Hello? Claire? There's some kind of shadowy figure watching me here? I almost did not see them. I was really focused on the rainbow road. Is this normal? Huh? Oh, I don't know. Maybe. I've never experienced this myself. That might always be there. Hello? Oh, okay. There they go. It just disappeared. See? If it left you alone, it's fine. I'm sure it's more scared of you than you are of it.
I don't know, it didn't seem scared. Hey, there's a star here. There's many stars here.
Okay, Melody. I have one last question to ask you before we can complete the ritual. A whole lot of magical power is currently being channeled into you, and we need a way to focus that. You want to be a paladin, and paladins derive their power from faith. I'm not really all that religious. Surprising. It doesn't have to be religious. Let's just try filling in the blank. My power is derived from my faith in... my faith in... In gay love. Oh, okay, hold on. Tree, heart, and diamond. What could these mean? Well, I'm already appealing. I'm really appealed by the heart. Most of all.
But I am a little curious about the other thing.
I wonder what happens if I click it. What? Oh, okay. What about the power of love? That is the cheesiest thing I've ever heard in my life. Yeah, I know. I just wanted to inspect it. But it could work. Especially with how inseparable you two are. This idea sounds pretty gay. Thanks, Allison. Thanks. I like it. If you're mainly doing this to follow your girlfriend around and heal her, then the source of your powers will never be far away. I don't see you two breaking up, but even if you did, you could still use feelings of platonic love as a power source. It's like a symbiosis sort of thing. Well, okay, maybe not the best mental image, but whatever. Okay, so this door leads to the power of the amorous paladin, strengthened by the faith in the power of love. Hey, welcome to the stream, Scoots. Use this path. Let's look at the other ones, because I'm curious about them, too. Well, I appreciate nature. I like living out in the woods, after all. That's a little spiritual, right? Could you rephrase that so it uses the word faith? I have faith in nature? I mean, that ecosystem, it sure is going. I guess I can work with that. Most things in nature have arcane energy. You can just borrow some of that. Nice choice, Mel. I think it's a good fit. This door leads to the path of the Woodland Paladin, strengthened by faith in Mother Nature. Choose this path? I don't want to commit yet. What's this one? Would faith in my own abilities count? What? Well, I feel like I'm kind of a natural healer. It just feels right. It can be any faith, and it could just be my faith in my ability to heal. You're telling me that you want to believe so hard that you have magical healing abilities, that the belief itself gives you the arcane power needed to actually cast healing spells. Which would in turn prove that belief, right? Like some kind of magical self-esteem Ouroboros? Is that what you're saying? Well, I...
I mean, resolute paladins are a thing, but it's not that simple, Melody. Hey, Mel did help me out last flu season. I probably would have been in her bed another week without her. And not only because she brought me medicine, I think just having her around helped. She has, like, a soothing presence. I mean, healing's healing, right? Just juice that up with some magic or whatever. Fine, if this is what you really want, then I guess I can make it work. So this door leads to the path of a resolute paladin, strengthened by the sheer force of will and faith in one's own abilities.
Okay. Alright, so I got three options. Nature, gay, or me. I mean, I gotta be honest. I'm really leaning towards gay. What do you guys think? The power of gay, right? I'm eating a chocolate. Mega gay? We do be the mega gay. Well, hey, you know what? There's only one reason I'm playing this game. Hey, so this game looks kind of gay. I'm here to commit to the mega gay and my girlfriend. So I will pick the gay door. Plus it's pink. It's freaking pink. It's my door. And with that, the choice was made. Super Lesbian Animal RPG. Act 1. Nice font. Several weeks later. Ooh, I'm getting my magical girl transformation on. Ooh, nice band. Oh, I actually almost licked the part. Not bad for a couple things I had in my closet and a few pieces of cheap gear off the internet. Your name is Melody Amaranth. You're a timid fox who lives near the small town of Greenridge on the scenic Sapphire Islands. Melody A. 100% matched. It's literally you.
Is this like my Tinder profile?
22, trans girl. Bi, Greenridge, 0 miles away, yeah. Likes quiet evenings, snow nature, chocolate, and girls. Dislikes bad stuff.
Yeah, me too.
You lived a quiet life with a few ambitions since high school, mostly content to let yourself coast along on autopilot. Now this game gets really loud. Hold on. Define bad stuff. You know, bad. But you always felt that something was missing. A few months ago, something finally clicked, and you came to two important realizations about yourself. One, you're deeply in love with your adventurous best friend, Allison Galetta. And you probably have been for a long time. As it turns out, the feeling was mutual. And two, if Allison has her heart set on becoming an adventurer, then maybe you could join her as a healer. Okay, enough hauling up in my house. I've read all the material Claire gave me and run through my mana management exercises 1,000 times. I think it's finally time to head into town and show everyone what I've learned.
Alright, hold on. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna adjust the volume. Let me put that and then I can put this back up there. The romance is part of the adventure. Okay, I think the volume is good now-ish. Let me know if it made it too quiet. I tried to make it kind of, you know, decent. Determines whether or not the game is considered art? Wait, hold on. There is an art toggle. There is a politics toggle? Controls how much of the game is politics. Why is the default 29? That's a really random number. Controls how much ludonarrative dissonance this game contains. Huh?
What does that mean? Wait, hold on. I have to look up this word. I know what ludonarrative means. Okay, I'm looking this up. It says, ludonarrative dissonance is a fancy way to say that the story and gameplay elements of a video game don't line up. When a game tells the player one thing through story and it contradicts itself through gameplay. I don't know what I should leave. I guess I could just leave it as a default. Do I want to get ready? Hold on. Let me see what they say about this in the game set, the game Twitter. Clearly. Okay. So if art is yes, wait, what? I don't know what happens if I adjust this. I know, I'm trying, I mean, I guess we could try to toggle it and see what happens. Do you guys think we should? Hold on, let's just turn it, let's just put it at max and see what happens, maybe. Let's just see what... Maybe it changes nothing. Inspect bookshelf. Been a while since I took a look at what's on the shelf. Let's see. Well, there's a few graphic novels I like, including some that Allison and Claire recommended for me. There's some regular novels too, but mostly ones I read as a kid. Man, how come I don't read much anymore? 0% and failed. Unfortunate. Do I just not have the energy as an adult? Well, you know, if you drop my HP down, you'll have a better chance of catching me. Oh, Lord, and there's all my overpriced college textbooks. I don't even want to think about my next semester of online classes and the loans and... Wow, this shelf is much more depressing than I remembered. Time to stop looking at it. Hold on, what if I now turn on... So that was... Wait, oops. So she kind of talked a little bit about the textbooks. What happens if I turn politics down to zero? I am so confuzzled. It does nothing? Damn it. I was expecting it to do something. Well, you know what? We're just gonna leave it 50-50. You know, I don't like to make choices. I don't like to commit, so we're doing 50-50.
Allison had a few of these autographed posters made last winter solstice. She gave them to everyone at our gift exchange and said they'd be valuable someday. Of course, it was only a gag gift, and then she gave everyone their real gifts. But I got her real good when I called her bluff and actually hung it up. Wow, that was a really obvious ploy for attention, huh? I can't believe it took me so long to figure out I had a huge crush on her. I bought this painting of Greenridge and Faith at our last art show. She really captured the town well.
I don't need a nap.
Pet beds always look so cozy. It's like a little nest made out of pillows.
I wonder what pet we have.
I'm almost jealous. Almost.
Do you guys think that I have a pet dog or a pet cat?
Whoops. Looks like I left my laptop open on my blog overnight. Oh yeah, I was looking through my photos and reminiscing, huh?
Wait, can I scroll down?
Wow, look at the way I was looking at Allison here. They weren't even dating yet. I guess this is why none of our friends was surprised when we announced we were dating a few months back. This is from when Claire and Jody first started their adventuring guild. They were so excited. Oh look, Jody's cute. I guess it's our adventuring guild now, huh? Claire says she doesn't really like this one though. She was standing close to the camera and she says it makes her head look huge. I can sympathize with that, honestly.
Hold on, I'm gonna adjust the volume still a little bit more. Let's do 50-50 on that as well. Oh, you got it right, Aesol. We got a cat. Look at this cutie. Look how big his eyes are.
Hi, Shadow. You okay looking after the house while I'm out?
Meow.
Good boy. If you need anything, I gave you permission to order delivery while I'm out, okay?
Wait, is no one taking care of the cat?
The self-refilling pet bowl. Definitely one of the greatest miracles of modern magic.
Oh, okay, that's right, they have magic. Yeah, cats are pretty independent, huh? They should take care of themselves, I guess.
Already had breakfast. It's nice having a fireplace in the winter. Makes it all warm and cozy in here.
What? What the heck? That should have caught me. Is it still broken? It's still broken. Really sorry about that, Aesol. I thought I fixed that this morning. I guess I didn't. I need to figure out why he keeps doing that. Hold on. What the heck? Oh my god, I just looked at it. Wow, okay. I just checked what it's doing, and it's not doing at all what it's supposed to be doing. Note to self, what is going on with the map? We're just gonna say Rocket Muse is a little broken right now.
Oh god, it smells really musty and dusty right now. When's the last time I cleaned it? I should probably avoid breathing in too much of the fireplace air before I put myself in a coughing fit. It's me and Allison. We look so cute together in this one. Allison has the same photo hanging in her house. I wonder if there's any coins between the couch cushions. Ooh, I found money! Wow!
What's up here?
Oh, my New Year's resolutions. It's June now, so let's see how many of these we've gotten done. Number one, read more. Well, reading that material in the healing spells has to count, right? Number two, be more outgoing. I'd say I'm working on that. Number three, get ripped. Nope. Well, I guess some progress is better than none.
Wow, this sounds like my resolution list. I have such a lovely house. I got a punching bag.
I've really gotten a lot of use of this punching bag Jody gave me. Every afternoon I've been doing some basic combat practice on it. And if my hands get sore, I take a break to practice healing magic on myself. It's no substitute for the real thing, but hopefully the practice pays off. I don't even remember what's in this barrel, and at this point I'm honestly afraid to check. I didn't even notice when washing them, but these jeans are way too small for me. Allison must have left them here at some point. They're still a little damp though, so she can get them some other time. Hello, flowers. These pink and yellow flowers symbolize me and Allison's relationship. Oh, that's cute. Or something like that. I asked Miss Leon what the nice romantic flowers plant would be, and she just gave me some to match my fur and Allison's hair. I mean, I guess that works. Okay, now to head for... Wait, is that a monster? What? Weird. They usually keep away from this part of the coast. I guess it's time to put my training to the test, though.
It looks like some weird pixels. Oh, it's okay. It's not. It's a humble hermit. Well, that's cute, actually. I like him. Can I keep him? Okay. Oh, now I have skills. Okay, so I can heal. I can attack. Let's attack it. Punch. Ha! Ha ha ha! Dodge. Doge. Dead.
I'm just glad that's over. I'll be sure to put this to good use. Ooh, a potion, nice. Hey, that wasn't so bad. I should be able to make it to the Green Ridge no problem. And if I get a little banged up, I can just use first aid. To use first aid outside of battle, open the menu and select skills. Also, wouldn't be a bad idea to hit up that save station right there. I'm guessing this?
This is a save station.
You can use it to save your progress.
Wow, look at all the save files I get.
So many.
Need to make sure I use them. Just in case I don't want to get softlocked. Ah, okay, that's oh god, the monster's coming after me. The monsters look interesting. Punch. Ah, it hit me. Get out of the way. Thankfully, I'm very strong. I'm kicking these guys up the butt.
That wasn't so bad.
Alright, cool. I'm doing great. Oh god, I can move so fast. Okay, so this is the beach. I think I'm supposed to go up, but let me look around. There's shells. There's a monster. Can I go around you? Okay, cool. Oh yeah, let me see if the save point heals me. I don't think so. Yeah, it doesn't. Okay. But I'm a healer, so that's fine. This is my purpose. Okay, so I just need to go... I guess up, yeah. There's a little chest down there. I want the chest. I like the way the art is done. It's very cute. I don't really know why I want to hurt these guys, though. They look really adorable. They have, like, hat shells. Ooh, that was a lot of money. So, said I can use my skill. First aid. Nice. I'm a competent healer. Okay, I'm assuming the ethers restore my mana. And what is this?
I've always wondered what is behind this door near my house, but I guess it's none of my business.
What? No, open it. Knock, knock. Ugh. I want to see what's behind the house. Or behind the door. I mean, it's, I guess, behind... near my house, is what she said. Okay, so if I go north, I gotta do Green Ridge. So south is beach to ooh! Oh my god, they're having a little picnic. Hello.
No, they're having a picnic. I better not disturb them. I didn't really need to go over there anyway.
You have a good picnic, guys. That is so cute. Man, this place is infested with monsters. She said they weren't around. Very suspicious. I wonder what the star means. What's over here? Oh, it's just the previous beach. Chest. Knife. I love money. Greenridge. Greenridge is a pretty nice place to live, I think. I mean, I've never lived anywhere else, but the people are friendly enough, and it's nice and quiet. Well, except for that whole wailing curse incident with Claire. That week was, extremely loud. But it's usually pleasant here at least 4 days a week.
That's good, at least 4 out of 7 we got pleasantness.
The wishing well. I should come back here with Allison.
Danger.
Danger.
Yep, that's what it says. Oh, hello.
Well, hello there, miss. The name's Raphael, traveling merchant extraordinaire. You wouldn't happen to know any adventure types in need of gear, would you? I was hoping to do a little business after dropping off a delivery for the Paladin Brigade, but there doesn't seem to be much demand today. Oh, I'm an adventure type in need of gear.
Really?
Well, I'm still new, I suppose. I'm a trap paladin in training, but I could use some equipment.
Why, my apologies. I should have known at a glance. You have the aura of a paladin.
I actually don't know any aura spells yet, but thank you.
In any case, perhaps some of my goods may aid in your paladin duties?
Okay, let's see what they got. Bow, leather gauntlet. A gauntlet to enhance your punches. Not particularly glamorous, but it's good. Simple yet effective piece of armor for beginner adventurers. Okay. Potion and tier revival. Okay. I think I'll get you. You. And, shoot, I can't afford the tier. Okay. If you need anything else, miss, I'll be in town the rest of the day. Wait, hold on. I don't have anything. Now let's equip. There we go. And let me actually go kill. I'll go kill another few crabs and I can buy the tier revival too. Crabs, fight me. Oh, enemy and enemy. Why are they all so cute? I don't want to kill them. They're so adorable. Oh god, they're all beating me up. Okay, that's good. It doesn't do as much damage. Let me do guard. That might help me. Dodge! And dead. Should be doing more damage now with my gloves. Yeah, now I can one-shot them. Oh, nice! Level up. And 28 gold. I think that was all I really needed. Wow, I think I'm really getting better at this. Allison's gonna be so impressed. Let's do this one. Let's beat it up. Now I can one-shot these losers. Oh, and when I level up, my health reset, but my mana didn't. Interesting. Okay, I'm learning. I'm learning things. I'm figuring it out. So now I can buy a tier, just in case. Thank you. Okay, let's see what we got around here. Oh, what the? Okay. I can walk on top of the tents. I'm king of the world! Can we go in this house?
I should probably mind my own business and stay out of strangers' houses. Wow. Melody, you are a better person than I am.
Whoop! Oh, yeah, frick. I did not mean to click load. Okay, I guess I have to talk to Raphael again. Great. I have to click save. I'm really good at this, guys. Well, I didn't lose much, but I have to be very careful that I don't do that again. I would definitely invade that house. I know, that's the instinct, right? That's the instinct instilled in us from an early age. Welcome to SlarPG Speedrun Birthday Stream. Yeah, the speedrun. I'm doing great with restarting from that one save point. Okay, once I kill this one, I'll be back to where I was before. Oh, they don't do any damage to me anymore, do they? We call that RNG manipulation and the speediness. Yeah. It changed a lot. I needed that extra 2 gold that I might have gotten. Okay. Save. That's what I meant to do. Oh, what should she sound like? Oh, hey, Melody, got a mit? Sounds too much like Allison.
Hey, Jody.
Hey, we missed having you around town lately. What you been up to? Everything okay?
I play it cool, obviously. Oh, not much. Did some spring cleaning around the house, got a little reading done, learned my first healing spells.
The fox who can't swim. Hashtag teach foxes how to swim. Oh no, foxy, you can't swim either? Oh no.
The usual.
Nice. I'm still not quite sure I understand that magic thing Claire did with you and Allison the other week, but it sounds like it paid off.
Ask about it. I was a little surprised you weren't there for the Fortuna Magical Ritual, actually.
Yeah, I guess it would have been more formal to have the whole guild there, but I doubt it would have been much help. You know I'm no magic expert. I leave that stuff to Claire. But hey, if you're picking up healing magic that quickly, maybe we'll be able to go on an expedition soon.
Well, I don't know if I'm quite ready for that yet.
Oh, it's not that scary, trust me. Claire hypes it up, but most of the places she wants to check out are harmless. Just some local wizard ruins where she thinks we might be able to find an artifact or two. It won't be like what happened last time. I promise.
Well, still, I don't know. Maybe sometime soon. But I'd like to practice a little more first.
Hey, it's cool. This is all new for you.
Go at whatever pace you're comfortable with.
Anyway, I assume you're looking for Allison, right?
Am I really that predictable?
Melody, you made 6 different posts on 2 different websites just saying I love my girlfriend in the last week. Mood.
It was definitely more than 6.
Well, I'm sure she's dying to see you too. Does floating constitute as swimming? JK, I can swim pretty well, but it hurts to know my brother and can't. I'm sure she just didn't feel like going for a swim. If she hasn't texted you about it or anything, I think she's got some big news for you.
Please tell me she didn't.
Oh, no, no. It's not another trampoline. What? What did she do with the trampoline? Did she break it?
Oh, thank God.
I guess I probably shouldn't ruin the surprise then. Allison can tell you herself.
You got me curious now. Well, I'd better get going. Have a nice day, Jody.
You too.
What's this? Library.
Monday, bingo night. Wednesday, Adventurers Guild meeting. Friday, anime club meeting. I need to come back on Friday. Glitchy, are you alright? Do you have trampoline PTSD? What happened with you? Ew, it's very nice in here. Oh my god, Moda's cute.
Hi, welcome to the... Oh, hey Melody.
Hi Mona, is Claire in right now?
No, your friend's not here. Hey, if you see her, could you tell her to get her crap out of the meeting room upstairs? I know you guys are on a schedule, but that doesn't mean she can use it as her personal office the rest of the week. I'd pack her up crap up myself, but she put some sort of hex or something on the door to keep me out. I'll have a word with her if I see her.
Mouse.
Oh, they have the new volume of my favorite comic series. I didn't realize the trade was out already.
I got no business in there.
The history section. They have several copies of that book about the history of the town.
Greenridge has been added to the lore section of Questlog.
Now let's look at that. Quest?
Oh shoot, there's a lot of stuff here.
Greenridge. This little town is the largest settlement on the Sapphic Islands. Or sorry, Sapphire. Sapphire Islands, with a population of a couple thousand people. Primarily beast folk due to proximity to the Beast Kingdom mainland.
Huh. Wait, so is not everyone a beast? Wait, so are there human people in this game?
What?
There's human people in this game? I thought that we were all furries. My mind is already blown. Are there human lesbians too?
The town as we know it today was founded centuries ago by a coven of witches who believed Fortuna, the goddess of magic, had personally blessed the islands.
Oh, so it's not even like the whole world has magic. It's like us.
Wow, that's interesting.
Why are there humans in my furry game? Yeah, what is up with that? I am like... No, I'm shook. I'm shook.
This is the magic section, but where are all the books? Oh well, maybe I'll take a look at some of these some other time. I don't want to keep Allison waiting for too long.
Did Claire take them all?
This is where we have our guild meetings, but I don't think anyone's there right now.
What's in the open room?
You got no misses back there.
Well, I am a busybody and Melody is not. Melody's like, I don't need to go there right now. What's this?
Jody's grill, her pride and joy.
I probably shouldn't barge into Claire and Jody's house uninvited. Are Claire and Jody dating? I hope so. They would be cute together. The little happy face. Shop!
Joy. I think someone's at the door.
Hold on, I'll get it.
Hi, we're not ready yet. Come back tomorrow for the grand opening, okay?
Oh, okay, I'm sorry. Okay, I'll come back. I love whoever those ones are. I already love them. This is Allison's place. Allison, why do you have an axe on the floor?
I wonder if this axe would be useful. I'll just leave it here, though. It's a little pointy for me.
Turn the radio on? This has got to be Allison's favorite song or something. She plays it all the time. It's a bop. Me and the cake are dancing.
That's Allison and me. Pull magnet. One of these days, we're going to redecorate in here, and we'll finally move this couch so it's not 1 foot away from the TV.
Yeah, I was noticing it's very close.
I think this is a poster from a show Allison went to in high school. Well, it would appear that Allison's not hiding in her wardrobe to pop out and surprise me. I wonder where she could be.
Okay, so she's not here, it seems. Oh wait, what's this? Oh, now I looked at that. Ooh, that's cool. Goddess Fortuna and a gift of magic.
This statue has got to be the most valuable thing on the archipelago, and also the fanciest.
Oh my god, look at this. Who are you? I gotta talk to you.
So, you whippersnappers fancy yourselves adventurers now, eh?
Bartholomew with the mew.
How old are you? 17? 18?
I'm 22. Sir.
22 years old? Kids these days, no gumption. Why, back when I was your age, I already tried to conquer the world twice.
Oh, Bartholomew, you're so funny.
If you kids didn't spend all day doing this planking nonsense or whatever it is you do, you'd have a lot more time to be productive. You could learn a thing or two from my granddaughter, Pepper. She's very ambitious. Just full of machinations, that one.
Well, it's been nice talking to you, Mr. Leon.
No, it hasn't.
Looks like they got quite the selection of spellbooks and accessories here.
Maybe I should go out and save some of my money.
I don't think I've ever been in this fortune-telling shop. I feel like I should probably find Allison first. She might enjoy getting her fortune told.
Grumpy fat cats? Where have I seen this before? Ooh, who are you? Hey, you and your friends are adventurers, right? Care to buy some spellbooks? Dad had a million of these old things collecting dust around the house, and we figured it'd be better to sell them to folks who would actually use them.
If these were Mr. Leon's, then aren't they a little dangerous?
Oh no, it's fine. He got rid of all the real scary ones years ago when he gave a villainy. At least, that's what he tells me.
Oh my god, Pepper is so cute! Look at her! She's a little villain in training. Mom, if these aren't dangerous, why don't you let me touch any of these spellbooks?
I'm sorry, honey. These are for grown-ups only. If something's dangerous, it's probably 10 times as dangerous in the hands of an 8-year-old.
Or 100 times as dangerous with me, right, Mom?
That's right, sweetie. But my dad's just a hoarder. When he was an adventurer, he'd just grab any old book he found, whether it was useful to him or not. We got plenty of spellbooks that would be useful for adventurous kids like you without being too dangerous, though. But you're gonna have to come back tomorrow if you'd like to peruse our wares. We ain't officially open yet. Let me see. Leon magic. Alright.
When I grow up, I want to be just like my grandpa. A powerful sorcerer? No! Evil! Anyway, the store's not really open today, so you should come back tomorrow and buy some spellbooks for my mom. Maybe all of them.
Wow, there's so many good characters in this game. Who are you?
Melody! Hi! How's my favorite paladin doing today? Oh, wow. I've only been a paladin for a few weeks. I'm already your favorite?
Well, you're my top four for sure. Don't know what a paladin really does, but I know you're giving it your all.
Oh, thanks. So, how have things been going at Piggly's?
Business hasn't been exactly booming, but hey, still living a dream. Hell, we got a good review from a food critic recently. I think they said we have ambiance. Did you know we had that? I don't even remember putting that on the menu.
Well, that's great. Why are you just standing outside the restaurant on your day off, though?
Hell, I was just waiting for Claire to stop by and grab her paycheck. I like giving to her in person. If I don't see her in 10 minutes, I guess I'll just leave it for her and Jody's mailbox.
I can remind her to drop by if I see her.
That'd be great. Well, I'm sure you're busy with your adventure business or whatever. I won't keep you.
See you, Beverly. It was nice talking. What's on this? Doesn't look like there's any jobs in the notice board today. Guess we'll have to check again tomorrow. I'd love to get a bite to eat, but Pickledy's is closed on Mondays.
Aw, what's on the menu though?
Today's specials. Beverly's homemade chocolate cake.
Ooh.
Big carrots.
Oh my god, this food is expensive.
This cake, this food costs more than the freaking tear that can revive people from the dead.
Wow, what's going on here?
These bottles have been thoroughly smashed. Almost definitely Allison's doing.
There's a lot of missing trees around here. If you see a monster or a litter bug, please call the local paladin brigade at 555-201-76727.
Alright, noted. Let's go look at what's in the other side really quick. That's a dead end. It's up here. Oh, hello. Is that a unicorn? Hello? Hi, Faith. It's nice to see you out of your office for a change.
Oh, hello, Melody.
Yes, it's been quite a week. Plenty of time for me to paint.
Of course, with Greenridge being quiet for this long, it's probably only a matter of time until someone causes a fuss.
Probably Claire. Does Claire really cause us much trouble? And the Paladin Brigade? Surely had bigger problems than her.
Melody, do you remember that time Claire accidentally made her and Jody's house float away into the sky?
You're going to have to be more specific than that.
Okay, I see your point, but still. She's our friend. Let's not assume the worst.
Sorry. You're right.
That was rude.
I admire Claire's ambitions. I just wish those ambitions didn't give me so many fires to put out as town guardian.
Often literally.
Who knows? Maybe you and Allison will be good influences on her now that you're in her guild. Oh, speaking of which, how's your training going?
It's going pretty well. I've been studying on my own, but I've already have a couple healing spells down.
Hell, that's quite impressive for someone who's never studied magic before, you know?
How did you manage to pick it up so quickly?
Claire didn't try any shortcuts with you, did she?
Guess I'm just a natural?
Well, I suppose it's not completely unheard of. I've always thought you'd make a natural healer, personally, for what it's worth. Would it be safe to assume you're heading over to Allison's to show her some spells?
You know, Jody assumed the same thing. What a coincidence.
Dear, you're always thinking about Allison.
What? Sorry, did you say something? I was thinking about Allison. We were just talking about her, and she's just so beautiful and amazing and great. And
what were we talking about?
I was saying, Melody?
Melody, snap out of it.
Keep daydreaming.
Melody, where are you going? Don't just walk away from...
Goodbye.
Sorry, I'm looking for my girlfriend.
Whoa, this place is huge.
Oh.
The Guardian's Tower. Even more fun characters in here.
Oh, there's a bird. Hello, bird.
Sup. I don't believe we met. The name's Bethanel, but everyone just calls me Beth Beast. And they're Mariana.
Hey.
Hello. Are you from around here?
We've traveled a long way on our righteous quest to see the local guardian. Almost 10 blocks, probably. We're here to ask her what she's doing to spread the love in Greenridge, and also to see if she'd like to hear our chill anime beats mixtape.
Oh, Faith's right outside, you know.
We didn't want to disturb her.
Shouldn't you kids be in summer school or something?
Actually, we're both on the honor roll. That's right, folks. This man can't put us in summer school.
What do you mean by spreading the love? Like being friendly and sending good vibes?
Good vibes are of utmost importance. Especially for our guardian. She sets the vibe for the whole town.
Bet the Beast sounds like a member of a heavy metal band.
Maybe she is. I haven't heard her chill beats yet. But you're thin, small. We also want to know if she's using her power to enact policies that will impact the town and its people in a positive way.
Oh, Beast doesn't really get to decide laws or anything. She's not the mayor. Her job is to fix magic-related problems around town and to help folks hurt by such things. You know, monsters, magic relics gone haywire, evil wizards, that stuff.
Well, I would say protecting us from evil wizards is a pretty good way to spread the love. I want to talk to her, though. We'll just wait for her in here.
Alright. Okay, well, it was nice meeting you.
Melody,
you're a paladin now, so I feel that I can entrust you with sensitive information regarding paladin brigade operations. Can you keep a secret?
Yeah.
Sure?
I accidentally wedged my sword in this crack in the floor, and I cannot get it out.
Oh.
Is... what? Oh, it is. It actually is in a little pink slit, the pink crack in the floor.
So now I'm just trying to act casual and stand here with it until everyone leaves. It's very stressful. I could try to help you get it out.
No, that would only cause a scene. Just think, how would the people of Greenridge react if they knew the new captain of the Paladin Brigade, their sworn protectors, was this incompetent? It would be all over the tabloids.
We have tabloids?
I wouldn't know. I don't read such things.
Everyone makes mistakes, Province.
This is the first mistake I have ever made in my life.
Also, I'm not actually joining the Paladin Brigade, by the way. I'm with Claire's Guild, not you guys.
Wait, really? You know what? Forget everything you just heard. I'm not stuck.
Poor Province.
Oh my god, Chet's cute.
Is he a chihuahua or a Doberman? I can't tell.
If you have an appointment with the Guardian, I'm afraid Miss Vincent isn't in right now.
Oh, I know. I saw Faith painting outside on my way in here.
So, do you need something else? A Dober Huawa? True. I think that's what he is. So, do you need anything else? I'm a little busy, Melody.
Not really. I guess I just want to ask how things were going. I mean, I feel like we haven't really talked much since high school.
Well, I started working out, and I got a job as a receptionist here at the tower.
Yeah, I can tell you work out, bruh.
That's about it.
Cool.
Sorry, I'm just a little preoccupied. Everyone's got problems they want Miss Vincent and the paladins to fix, and I'm the one who has to filter those requests. I've gotten 3 separate calls today from folks claiming a wizard had broken into their homes and erased their memories of their email passwords in their sleep.
Oh no! Is that what happens?
That happens to me a lot, too. I understand the worry.
Did that really happen?
No. I now have to file a thorough report for every one of these calls. So I should get back to that.
Poor Chet. Busy, busy.
Oh, who's this?
It's definitely the evil lizard.
Hey, Melody.
Faith told me you're a paladin now. Welcome to the club. Not the club as in the brigade, of course, but you know what I mean. You are... Bella.
Thanks, Holly.
What specialization did you go with, by the way? I don't think Faith mentioned it.
Oh, I'm an amorous paladin.
Ha! I knew it. That's so fitting for a lovey-dovey type like you.
Faith, I am pretty gay.
Don't worry, kid. I meant that as a compliment. You just know what you're all about, and you're using that to your advantage. Just like how I know that I'm all about being the biggest, strongest healers this town's ever seen. You definitely look really strong. Say, you know, we actually have an amorous paladin on our team.
Wait, really? Who was it? Rhett's?
Nope. It's Province.
Oh my god, seriously?
Seriously. She's all about her love for the town and all the people in it and wanting to protect them.
but she shows it in some interesting ways, most of which involve frowning. Don't tell her I told you that, by the way. She's a little embarrassed about it. She thinks people wouldn't take her seriously if they knew. But yeah, there's a lot of different types of love you can derive your powers from. Although I have a feeling I already know what you're going with.
It's exactly what you're thinking. Everyone knows I'm really gay for Allison.
Well, I'm real happy for you, kid. Just be careful. Having your feelings for your girlfriend be the source of your magic as well. It's a lot of pressure to put on one relationship. You two seem real happy together. Try not to let things get weird because of all this.
I didn't even realize that would put a lot of pressure on our relationship when you, it's fine. It's fine.
Thanks, Holly. I'll do my best.
Oh, and one more thing. It's not much, but I figured you'd put it to good use.
Ooh, a staff! Oh, it's a little bent.
Yeah, Staves and I don't really get along. I whack stuff a little too hard with them.
It looks cute in my hand, though. I love it.
Still works, though. It'll give your spell casting a little more oomph compared to casting empty-handed. I mean, provided you actually equip it, you know.
Well, thanks, Holly. I'll be sure to put it to good use.
Knock him dead, kid. Knock him alive, because you're a healer.
A little bit.
I'm sure it's fine. Let's see. Kind of makes the weapon I just bought useful, whatever. A little bent, that's worse than my back. You better make sure that you stay away from her, then. Holly could fix your back, actually. She could fix it physically or with magic.
Nice sword, Rhett. Is that a new one?
Oh my god, Rhett is cute. I know I keep saying this about, like, all the characters, but I just really love the art style in this game, guys. Plus, I mean, most of the characters are girls, so.
Actually, it's an old one. I found it buried in my attic the other day. The old guardian always made us use regulation armor and gear and stuff, so I never got to use this one back in the day. This bad boy was just collecting dust until I realized that Faith would totally let me use it. I still got a lot of polishing left to do, though.
Oh, she must be Chet's sister. Something you just noticed, there are a lot of pink foxes.
And where?
I only seen one pink fox.
Isn't it just going to get dirty when you use it?
Yeah, but if my sword's real big and shiny, then I might scare off evildoers without actually doing much to exert efforts. That's actually happened to me a few times before, believe it or not.
I mean, I wouldn't want to get hit with that thing, so I guess it makes sense. I'll let you get back to that then. See you around.
Man, I should try that. Just swinging around a huge sword. Oh, a training room.
A training dummy, huh? I bet Allison would love to practice some of her moves on this thing.
What's this say?
Combat 101, tips for beginner adventurers. The most important aspect of combat is the management of two resources, your health and mana. In combat, both are represented as a pair of gauges below your portrait. Your HP is green, your MP is pink. Your HP represents how much damage you can take in battle. HP can be recovered, blah, blah, blah.
Okay, what's star power?
In addition to HP and MP, you have access to special resource known as star power. The power is represented by the star-shaped gauge located to the right of your name in combat.
Okay.
Star power is, in basic terms, something you gain for doing your class's job well. For offensive classes, star power is primarily gained by performing standard attacks and also simple magic attacks. For healer classes, star power is primarily gained by performing healing spells. For tanks, okay, by taking hits. When you build star power, you can then spend it on special star power-based abilities. Many of these are highly powerful attacks or particularly useful utility spells. However, star power resets at the end of every fight. Don't let it go to waste. Be sure to use it when you have it.
Okay. Okay. Self-explanatory, I think. Oh, hold on. I'm getting pinged. He's pinging me.
Okay. Oh, hold on. Actually, really quick. Hold on. Okay. Sorry about that. My room is really dark. I forgot to turn the light on. And the sun is going down. And it was getting kind of spooky in here. Like, really spooky. Okay, so Allison can only be in one place. This way. Meow shroom. Oh no. They don't have arms. Oh. Oh dear, okay, that's not good. 4. What does that do? How is that thing faster than me? It has no legs. Okay, oh, the star power is like... Okay, so if I do 5 things, it fills the gauge up. Interesting. Alright, let's see where Allison may be. Oh, what's this? Wait. I know there's something here. What is this? Is this some kind of treasure map? Let me take a closer look. 1, 2, 3, 4, north. What? 3 trees. Well, it's not super clear, but I guess I'll keep an eye out for this treasure. Okay. Yeah, I will keep an eye out for whatever that is. Oh, what's this? These flowers seem interesting. Do they grow like this naturally? Maybe. Hey, you're blocking my way. Poop snake. It's the Ouroboros. I mean, honestly, I want these guys to be like my pets. They're so cute. I don't want to kill them. Can we just be friends? Hits really hard. Oof. At least I healed myself really good. I'm very close to leveling up, so if I level up, I should be good. Oh, hold on. So, it was... What was it? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. 2. Oh, 1, 2. Wait, was that wrong?
Maybe this isn't the right one. There's three trees around it. Oh, okay, I accidentally messed up. Aha! Neat. I didn't realize I clicked it twice. So fast, Hoop Snake. But at least I leveled up so I can heal. Fantastic. No reason to have separate saves yet. One of these days there's gonna be something secret behind there. It's Allison!
Allison?
What, Mel?
What are you doing all the way out here? This felt like taking a hike. Wait, what's that? Did you get hurt?
Oh, this? It's just a scratch. Funny story, actually. See, I was just minding my own business on break at work, smashing some bottles I had lying around for fun. You know, same old, same old. But I noticed that one of the bottles I smashed had a treasure map hidden inside. Awesome, right? I figured my mom must have buried some treasure out here and hid the map in a bottle at the house. Anyway, long story short, I got jumped by a monster and chased it here to give it a piece of my mind. But I kind of got away.
Here, let me see where you hurt. I want to try something.
Huh? Oh, sure.
Okay, Melody, focus. Remember what you studied. Positive thoughts. Square breathing. Channel your mana into your palms.
Oh. Oh. Okay. Ooh. Melody casts first aid.
Oh my god, it worked!
Well, Mel! That's incredible! You can really pull off healing spells like that already?
Oh, it's just an entry-level first aid spell. It took me like 2 weeks just to get that one down, even with Claire's magic boost, and I can't exactly do much more than that. Did you really feel better?
Yeah, I feel great. And give yourself some credit. Going from knowing zero magic to be able to do that is pretty amazing. Oh.
Oh dear.
Mel? I know this is a lot to ask, but you think you can lend me a hand here? Yeah, I want to see what you can do. Oh my god, whole hound. Look at how cute it is. Why do I have to fight them? I want to adopt him. He's just a little good boy. Oh wow, he's strong. He's strong. See how much damage you can do. Allison can do pretty good damage on it. Well, thankfully it just seems to be attacking me. Yeah, I'm fine.
What? Huh?
It went in a hole. I know, I don't want to kill it. Let's guard? Allison gets to charge her star power just by attacking. That's pretty nice. Oh, it's double attack. Melody, certified healer and meat shield. Oh, wow, that was a lot of damage. Wait, what the heck? Wait. Here's Allison. give Allison a little peck on the cheek to boost morale and raise all her stats by 15%. Bruh. Awesome. I'm gonna kiss her. Melody attempts to kiss Allison. Yeah! Get him! Get him! Oh, wow. She can also kiss Melody. Give Melody a little peck on the cheek. Or she can use her star... Oh, so I don't have to use all my star power. Wow. Let's do this. Roundhouse kick! Smack it! Nice! Didn't even break a sweat. Sick! I love the power of gay. I think we scared it off.
Isn't it a little weird to see a monster this close to town? I mean, forget the fact that we keep seeing them everywhere else, but that was very odd.
Eh, it happens. It's just a whole hound. I find things like that poking around my garbage at least once a year. So, anyway, hey, I haven't seen you in forever. Taste the rainbow, or else. Really liking that new look. It's adorable. No, you know what? I like to be adorable.
You really think so? I was trying to go for a healer look. It's not too much, is it?
No way, you look great. I mean, I always think you're adorable. But today especially so. So, since you're here and I'm no longer busy, why don't we, like, do something together? I missed having you around, you know. Let's go do something fun.
What, like, couple stuff? Like a date?
Yeah, totally. Normal couple stuff. No magic, no guild, no monsters. Just a chill afternoon together.
You know what? You're right. I think a relaxing day off would be good for me. Or at least half a day off.
That's the spirit.
Did you have something in mind for us to do?
A kiss would be a start? Heck yeah or heck yeah.
Heck yeah.
Wait. Wait. I have. Damn it, Nightbot, I need to put a marker on this moment. Oh, that was really funny. I was not expecting that. Nightbot, I guess I need to re-authenticate you.
So, what now?
I don't know, we'll figure something out. Let's just go around town and find something fun to do. That must be her joy music. Can I talk to her? Nope, but that's not what I meant to do. All right, let's go.
There we go. Now we're together. And actually, guys, that is where we're going to end the stream for today. I've had a very long day, and I need to eat dinner. So, we'll come back to this, though. Like I said, this game will be replacing Pokemon Conquest, so don't worry, it won't be very long before we get back to this. I will play much more of this game on Sunday. In fact, you might have a hard time stopping me from playing this game. It's really fun and cute so far. But we're going to save that, and we're going to go over to drop off the night with a fun raid.